The red facade of the State Library marks 100 years of existence. We get the details on the space. Bengaluru commuters are most probably victims to air pollution. Details coming up later in the bulletin. A look inside one of city's charming used bookstores on Church Street, blossoms. Hello and welcome to NSoJ Weekly News Roundup. I am Deepika. Located inside the lush greens of Cubbon Park is the State Central Library. The red facade of this building does not give away just how old it is. Celebrating 100 years, the library is home to over 5 lakh books. It also has been a favorite reading getaway for many visitors who come to study, read papers and browse through the extensive collection. The library also caters to individuals with special needs. The Braille section is currently under renovation and will soon include audiobooks, internet facilities, along with study materials for competitive exams.
Basically, in our library, on the occasion of this centenary celebration, we are doing that upgradation and modernization of our Braille section and introducing the internet that is called browsing center to the common readers, and that is the public. And that audio books, especially for Braille readers.
The busy city streets showcase the bustling life of this city. What it does not show, however, is the threat it poses to life. The haze of smoke that looms in the air tell of a tragic truth we ignore. Tristan Mark has the report.
Bumper to bumper traffic, the wait for signals to turn green, and the time taken to cross important stretches in the heart of the city are issues familiar to any Bengalurian. But are Bengalurians ready to compromise on health? The city's air pollution limits has become a toxic space to live and work in.
Here at the Peenya Junction, air pollution is 26 times above the limit that the World Health Organization considers safe. It's also 13 times higher than the limit our country has on air pollution. Such high levels of particulate matter emitted from running engines and poor vehicle maintenance can lead to an increase in health risk for commuters and for traffic enforcement officers who are standing here for hours at these busy junctions.
At 2 feet level, if at all the air is not of a good quality, we don't have an ambient quality air. So actually that is already at a permissible limit, it is above. So we are all at risk. So there are many particles in that, about 4,000 particles are there, no? Some are causing real health effect. Apart from a regular risk factor like smoking and other things, these risk factors are additive. So in terms of lead, in terms of other things, there are a lot of things are going on. These are all outdoor air pollution, is a risk factor for COPD or lung health will be poor. So everyone is at risk, no age is prone. It is nothing like genetics, these cancers will come and all. Whoever is exposed to this thing, all age group are susceptible. Elderly or extremes of age group are susceptible because of their immunity and all. They can catch up pneumonia. They can become much bad because their reserve is poor.
In Bangalore, 3,000 traffic policemen are trying to manage 50 lakh vehicles. And given the alarming pollution figures, their health is suffering.
ತುಂಬ ಹೊಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಕೆಲವು ಹಳೆ ವೆಹಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಇದಾವೆ, ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಂತಿದೆ. ಮತ್ತು ಹಳೆ ಇಂಜಿನ್ಗಳಿಂದ ಮತ್ತು ಕ್ಯಾಬ್ಗಳು ಮತ್ತು ಇದು ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿ ಕ್ಯಾಬ್ಗಳು ತುಂಬ ಹಳೆವೆಲ್ಲ ಓಡ್ತವೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ, ಅದೆಲ್ಲ ಆರ್ ಟಿ ಓದ ಹಿಡಿದಾಕಿ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ.
ಸಾಫ್ಟ್ವೇರ್ ಕಂಪ್ನಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದರೆ, ಒಂದು ಕಂಪ್ನಿಲಿ 50 ಕ್ಯಾಬ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಅವನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ಸಲ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಒಂದು ಓಲ್ ವಾಪಸ್ ಎರಡು ಓಲ್ ವಾಪಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ಟರೆ ಆ 50 ಕ್ಯಾಬು ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ತಪ್ಪುತ್ತೆ.
ವೈಲ್ ಕಾರ್ ಯೂಸರ್ಸ್ ಎಸ್ಕೇಪ್ ದ ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ದೇ ಎಮಿಟ್, pedestrians and commuters waiting at the bus stop become the most likely victims of these dangerous emissions.
It is all unknown, the traffic problem, and there's all the vehicle problem. So maximum people are taking own vehicle, that is the problem. Because I am here in 2000 year in Bangalore, so that time Bangalore is different, now is Bangalore is totally different. It's like in Mumbai. So my personal opinion is that we are taking public transport, it is best for our country.
While the city's traffic continues to clog roadways and pollution levels hitting all-time highs, concerned citizens are opting for carpools, public transport or pedaling into work.
Now who doesn't love a good bargain, and especially if it's a book? Located along the bustling Church Street, this three-storied bookstore is a retreat for all bookworms. Blossoms is a book lover's paradise, and the second-hand shop is tagged floor-to-ceiling with thrillers, drama and classic children's tales. The tiny space hasn't discouraged regulars and the newbies, one among a handful of such stores in the city. Blossoms will be opening a bigger store a few blocks up.
I think reading is wonderful. I think every human being should be reading a book. You know, they should start right now, no matter what genre, what author they like. I think it's one of the best things that you can do with your time. And it really keeps your brain sharp. And there is nothing like reading a book.
That's it from us for now. Keep watching this space for more news.